Do you always find it difficult to color grade your images in Photoshop? In this video, we will show you the step-by-step guide to color grade your images to get a perfect skin tone in Photoshop using Camera Raw. Hello guys, this is Whispro Media. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. In the last video we posted, we showed how we were able to snap these pictures to get a perfect pre-wedding portrait inside the studio. We had a lot of people asking us to show how we did the color grade to get this perfect image. So in this video, we will show you how we moved from here to here. So this image now, this is how it is from the camera. This is how it is direct from camera. This is after color grading. Show you on today's video, we will show you how to color grade your pictures to get this skin tone, and we will equally show you how to save your presets. Even if you snap picture tomorrow or any other day and you like this very preset that you have created, you can apply it on your pictures. So a situation whereby you did a preset for one of these pictures, you did a preset, you use this one to create your preset, and you want to apply the same preset on this one, I will show you how to create it and save it, and then show you how to apply it. Watch to the end of this video if you are interested in learning how to do it. You should already know that the best format to snap your picture is RAW. The reason why you should snap your images RAW is because when you snap RAW, you can be able to manipulate the colors, the exposure, and get whatever that suits you, what you want to achieve. You get, so you can choose to manipulate the color of the background, color of the clothes, whatever. You get, so that is the best. That is the reason why you should snap your images in RAW. So these images, we snap them RAW. These ones, we snapped them RAW. And this is what the RAW file looks like. It's taking time to load because these files are heavy. This is a RAW file. This is another RAW file. It do take time to load because these files are very heavy. Yeah. So this is what the RAW files look like. So I will just pick one of them and then show you guys how we color grade. So the first thing you will do is to drag the image to Photoshop. Yeah, that is just in the Photoshop. Yeah, allowing the Photoshop to boot. Yeah, so this is the image is imported into the Photoshop. So the number one, the first thing I do once I import to Photoshop is to rotate it. I will rotate the image. So I go to this place where they have this crop sign, and then click on rotate. Then I go back here. Yeah, this is an amazing image. This is very fine. So the first thing I do after rotating the image is changing the profile. And once you snap a picture with whichever profile you snapped with and you import it into Photoshop, Adobe Photoshop, Adobe will automatically change the profile of your picture to Adobe Color. So you will need to change the profile, color profile, to what it was when you snapped it. So what you will do is just come here, click on this four brass profile, then you have favorites, then close this Adobe RAW, you close this guy, then you open camera matching, you open this guy. It has faithful, landscape, neutral, portrait, monochrome, and standard. So whichever profile you use to snap your picture, that is what you will use. On my own case, what I used is neutral, so I'll just click on neutral straight up, then go back to where I was before. So I'll come back to this setting, and then I will go to basic. Is the first thing I'll go to. So the number one thing on basic is temperature. Temperature is about the warmness or coldness of the image. Yeah, so I love to, this is how it looks, this is how it is from the camera when it snaps. Well, we shot this on 6000, so I love to take it down a little bit to 5000 something, then I'll take down the tint. I take the tint down to around 9 or 10 or so. Yeah, then this is exposure. This exposure plays a very big role, like a situation whereby the picture is underexposed. This is where you brighten it up, and that is the main reason why you should snap your images in RAW, because if it's not RAW, you cannot be able to brighten this up if it's underexposed. So you increase it a little bit, then increase your contrast. See before and after this way, just increase your contrast a little bit. I love to increase it. Then normally I do reduce the highlights. Yeah, I do reduce my highlights. Then my shadows, I increase my shadows a little bit because this is a black look and I will need to get the details of the outfit. Yeah, so I just increase my shadows a little bit. Take my white down. No, I will take it down. I used to take it down. Then my black, I should take my black down a little bit. Yeah. Then this texture, I don't touch it. I just leave it how it is. When you double click on any of this, it go back to how it is. I don't touch clarity either. So I just allow it to stay where it is. Then the haze, I increase. This is what it looks like. So I just increase the haze a little bit. Then I bring down saturation. I don't touch vibrance, I don't touch it. So it's just saturation, I try to bring down a little bit. Yeah, then after I'm done with basic, then the second step I will do is I will go to color mixer. This color mixer comprises of HSL, that is hue, saturation and luminance. So this hue, saturation and luminance is in Photoshop, is in Adobe Lightroom and Camera Raw, you call it. So I think all of them serve the same purpose. So you just use the one that suits you very well. So I come here, I bring this guy down, this red, I increase it. I don't bring that down anything. Orange, I increase it a little bit. I take my yellow down. Yeah, bring it down towards orange. Then green, take the green down towards the minus. So I don't touch aquas, blues, purple or magenta. Reason being that there's nothing in this image that's showing this color, so it's as good as touching it, manipulating it, increasing it or reducing it is as good as not doing anything, because it does not have any effect on this picture. So the next thing I do is I go to saturation. After you go to saturation, I increase my red a little bit, then increase my orange, then I reduce my yellow. The reason why I reduce my yellow and I will equally reduce my green is because I don't want the background to be getting so much attention. So the purpose of this color grade for me is to get a skin tone. I'm working basically on the skin tone, so I wouldn't want the background to be dragging attention with the object, with the picture, the object that is in the picture. So I wouldn't want the background to be dragging attention. That is why I had to tone down the colors of the background a little bit so that the object will pop out. So that is the reason why I had to tone these two guys down, because there's yellow on the background, so I had to bring it down. Then green on the background, I had to bring it down too. Yeah, so after this, I don't touch these guys because they are as good as not touching them. So I go straight down to calibration. On this calibration, I will check to what suits you normally, I guess. But then I do increase this guy a little bit, increase my saturation small. Just I do touch the saturation, see, small. I try not to change these colors unless if I want to achieve a dramatic setting. But then don't forget that the purpose of this whole thing is just to get a flawless skin tone, a good skin tone that suits my color, what I like. So this here is where you check how it is before and after. See, just this whole thing we did now, see before and after. So after this, then I go back to basic again to know if I can take down the highlight a little bit here, increase the exposure slightly. Yeah, so this is what I'll be working with. This is what I'll work with. So this is before and after. Before, after. So when you want to open this image, don't just click open. It's either you hold shift, open smart, open objects, or you click on this arrow here, then you open as objects. The reason why you will have to open it as an object, the reason why you will have to open it as an object is maybe you are done with the color grade and you discover that there are some things you need to modify. You just double click here and it will take you back to camera raw. And you just increase, reduce, or do whatever you need to do to still get the color that suits you perfectly. So this is how I did my first color grade. And the next thing after this color grade is to retouch it with Retouching Academy skin retouching, to work on the textures on the skin and then remove blemishes. Before we start the retouching, I will show you how to copy your preset to copy the preset to another picture and how to save it for reference purposes. So after you are done with the editing of this one, you are done with the whole color grading and you want to apply it on these ones, so you don't need to start afresh and start doing the same process on this one. So what you just quietly do is these two down, you just highlight both of them, rotate both of them ASAP, then come here, right click, copy edit settings, come here, paste it straight up. Everything that was there is here already. Then come here, do the same thing, paste. So what you can just do is to modify it a little bit, you guess, because it's a totally different image kind. So you just do minimal modification. That is how to apply it. And then how to save this preset. For instance, now I did this preset and I liked it and I want to save it. How to save it is this last more image settings, click here, then go to save settings, you click on save settings, then default is here, yeah, save. You name it what you remember. Let me just use color grade to save it. So when I use color grade to save it, then I import this tray, command A, we open as a smart object. This tray now is imported inside Photoshop. You want to work on this fourth one. So this one, you have to import this one inside Photoshop to the same way you imported the others. But then where to get that preset you saved is this second to the last, yeah, preset shifts. So you come here to go to user preset, open it, you click on it, the color comes in automatically. You just go back and rotate it. It saves you the stress of going back and forth and all. So the best you can do is just to modify it a little bit to suit you. Then after you are done adjusting it to what suits you, you open it as an object to Photoshop. When you open it as an object to Photoshop, you then go ahead and do your retouching. This is the end of this video. If you have any question you don't understand, or if you have complications, you can easily go back to watch it again to understand the detailed explanation. You can just practice it with your laptop as you're watching the video. That way it will help you to learn faster and implement it. So thank you for watching this video. If you find this video informative and educative, please hit the subscribe button. Don't forget to like and share and give us thumbs up so that YouTube can share this video to more people who might need this knowledge. Thank you.